Hello and welcome back again to MBAbullshitDotCom. So our topic for this video is reorder point, alright, or the basic reorder point model. Remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. Alright, so this video talks about the basic reorder point model, and after this you can move on to my next video on MBAbullshit.com about reorder point with safety stock. Also check out my free related video on the economic order quantity model on MBAbullshit.com. Alright, so let's start with a story. Let's say your friend Mike wants to buy basketballs from a factory and sell them to his neighborhood. He estimates he'll sell about 1,200 basketballs per year, so that is the yearly demand. At first, Mike thought of just buying a fixed 100 basketballs at the beginning of every month from the factory, which will equal his 1,200 basketballs by the end of the year. The problem is, Mike worries that he doesn't know when he might run out of basketballs. If that happens, he'll have to wait until the next month to get a new batch of basketballs. He might end up with no basketballs to sell until the next month, when a new delivery arrives. He'll have to send customers away. His friend Lily suggests, "You should order a new batch of basketballs." Or she says, she's a girl, right? "You should order a new batch of basketballs even when you have only 50 basketballs remaining, just to be sure that you never run out." Okay? And his other friend and fishing partner, Janet, says, "Lily, that's too much. Mike should order a new batch of basketballs when he has only one or two basketballs left. That should be good enough." Alright, so who should Mike listen to? Lily or Janet? Well, by the way, Lily is adorable and cute, but Janet is hot and sexy. So that makes decision making a little bit more difficult, a lot more difficult for Mike. Because he has to choose between cute advice from a cute babe and a sexy babe. Alright, so in MBA bullshit language, Lily is suggesting a reorder point of 50 basketballs, while Janet is suggesting a reorder point of 1 or 2 basketballs. Alright? So let's say that every time Mike orders a new batch of basketballs, it takes 4 working days for the new batch to be delivered. And we call that lead time. Okay? And let's assume further that there are 250 working days each year. Now remember, from earlier in the story, I already said that the demand is about 1,200 basketballs a year. So again, who should Mike listen to? Lily or Janet? For this, we use the reorder point formula, which looks like this. It's very simple. Reorder point equals the demand per year divided by the working days per year multiplied by the lead time. So all these figures are given. So we now know that the reorder point is 1,200, based on these variables, 1,200, okay, is 1,000, demand 1,200 per year, demand, divided by the working days per year, 250, which we get from this, multiplied by the lead time. And the lead time is 4 working days. Remember? Multiplied by the lead time. And we simplify this, the same thing. Okay? We simplify it. It's the same thing. It's just up here. We get the reorder point of 4.8 times 4 or 19.2. So Mike should immediately place a new order as soon as he has only 19.2 basketballs remaining. So he has to say sorry to both Lily and Janet because they are both wrong. Now, to be safe, we should round this off to the higher whole number. Well, that depends on your professor, but personally, I like to round it off to the higher whole number of 20. Okay, so Mike should immediately place a new order as soon as he has only 20 basketballs remaining. Our reorder point is 20. And the reason why I do this is because obviously you cannot purchase 0.2 of a basketball. Okay, 0.2 of a basketball. Alright, so that's as simple as it is, the reorder point. So remember to share it if you like it on MBA Bullshit, on Twitter, we're simply known as at MBA Bullshit, facebook.com/MBA Bullshit, and please just, or simply, please forward my YouTube links on your email, or post it on your Facebook, or any other social media which you prefer. Alright, so have a great day, and goodbye.